गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, माय नेम इज तनुश्री दड़ाई फ्रॉम सिविल इंजीनियरिंग ब्रांच एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू योर थ्योरी वन पेपर व्हिच नेम इज स्ट्रक्चरल मैकेनिक्स। सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ए मटेरियल, ओके, लाइक योर ड्यूरेबिलिटी, स्टिफनेस, ब्रिटलनेस एक्सेट्रा। देन वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द ductile material and brittle material, okay? So today we will discuss about the deformation of axially loaded members, okay? In your syllabus only linear materials are there, okay? So deformation of axially loaded members means if a body subjected to axial load, that means in the x-axis or in the y-axis axial load, then what kind of deformation will occur or exerted by the object or the body? So you can calculate from this formula, okay? So now first of all you see this is a body and this body subjected to tensile load, okay? This is a force which is pulling in nature, okay, which is outward in the direction, that means pulling in nature. So here also the body is applied by tensile load. Then due to the tensile load, the body is stretched out up to this much. That means the original shape of the body is up to this much. Then due to the loading system, it is stretched out up to this much. That means the length is increased by this much, which is known as your delta. Okay, this is the extra length which is stretched by the tensile load. So now, as per the stress definition, what we will know? We know that the stress equal to force per unit area, correct? So this is your force which is defined as P and area, that means the area of this body. So this is your known as stress value, that means the sigma value equal to, if we divide the force per unit area, is known as your stress value, correct? Then we know that as per the definition, so strain equal to change in length or change in dimension divided by original dimension. So the change in this body is delta, correct? And the original length of the body is L, okay? Due to the loading system, only the length is affected, so that as the dimension change, we only consider the length part, okay? So according to the Hooke's law, we know that the capital E equal to sigma by epsilon, that means your stress by strength, correct? So the stress formula you take as equation 1, the strain formula you take as equation 2, and the Hooke's law, that means within a elastic or within a elastic limit, the stress is directly proportional to strength, okay? So that time the Young's modulus is considered as the constant value, okay? So take this formula as equation 3. So now put the equation 1 and equation 2 value in the equation 3, that means in the place of sigma put P by A, which we can derive from this, and then in the strain value we can put the value of delta by L. So by calculating or by deriving this whole formula, we got the value of PL by AE. So as a whole, the deformation value is known as your PL by AE. Okay. So this is for only one loading system. Okay, a single load is acting here, so that we just put your delta equal to PL by AE. So where your capital E is your modulus of elasticity, or also it is known as Young's modulus. Okay, then your capital A, which equal to cross sectional area of the body or the structure. Then capital P equal to compression or tension force which is act on that particular body. Then delta is your value of the total elongation or the value of the deformation. Then L is your undeformed length or the original length of the body. That means up to this much to this much. Okay. And E or epsilon is the normal strain. Then your sigma is your normal stress. So now comes to the multiple loading system. So while a body subjected to more than two loading system, then how can we calculate the elongation? So for that time, the elongation equal to summation I equal to 1 to the n and delta I. That means we have to add each of the force, not at a time, at an individual time, then just add that. The sum of the single individual section with a single loading system we have to calculate first. Then after that, we just put the each value of the P, L, E and A. Then we calculate the total elongation of the whole body. Okay. So now, this is the question from the deformation part. Okay, regarding this formula. So here, it is given by a figure form. And here, the force is provided and the body dimension also given. Then Young's modulus value also given. Then the capital D represent the diameter of the this figure. Okay, diameter of the this figure, and the small d represent the diameter of this figure. Okay, so while you calculate the area of this part, we have to take this diameter value, that means 0.618 inch. Okay, and while we calculate the area of this part, then we have to take the D value as capital D, which is your 1.07 inch. And the loads are given here as KIPS. Okay, it is a unit of the force, and 1 KIPS equal to your 1 pound force. That means 1000 pound force. Okay, so 1 KIPS equal to 1000 IB. Okay, the pound force is known as an IB. Correct. So next is your, first of all, take a look on the solution part. So what we have to do, divide the load, that means this whole diagram, into components at the load application point. Okay, according to the application of the load, you have to subdivide the whole structure into individual section, like your free body diagram. Okay, so apply a free body diagram or free body analysis along the whole body and each component to determine the internal forces. Okay, then evaluate the total elongation of the load. Correct. So first of all, we have to subdivide the whole system and source its internal forces
individually. Correct. After that, we have to calculate. So now we will discuss this whole solution in the next class. So today this much. Thank you.